Tonight, a flag burning in the street, and Stephen Colbert compares Donald Trump to the Nazis. Plus, a father gives us a proper lesson in parenting. And finally, the Muslim invasion of London. It's Friday night. We've got videos for you. So get ready, because it's all unfiltered. Hello, I'm Dennis Michael Lynch, and I thank you for joining me on this Friday night. Like every Friday night, we're going to play you a few videos that they're not necessarily showing on the mainstream media, but that we believe that you want to see, need to see, and we should be discussing. And to do that with me, joining me now is Tom Ruskin. He's a retired NYPD detective and head of CMP Protective Services and Investigations here in New York. Across from me is the beautiful Liz Stern. She's the founder and CEO of Diva Moms. And also with us is Ben Weingartner. He's a regular on the show, and he's also CEO of Change Up Media. All right, so the first video is yours, Ben, and tell us what we're going to see.
This is a video of late-night host Stephen Colbert, shall we say, critiquing Donald Trump's response to the Orlando jihadist attack.
All right, first of all, before I figure this out, I've got to think like Trump. So first, I'm not going to take my meds. Okay. I see patterns where none exist. Okay, let's see here. Okay, let's see all the options here. Okay. Trump is saying Obama is not smart because he won't say radical Islam. Trump. Oh, wait, I'll figure this out. Trump then says, this is inconceivable. So something must be going on. Probably because Obama is a Muslim, and that's a bad thing.
No. All right, Ben, what's your original reaction to that?
There's so many directions that we can go with this, from the bias of the media to comparing the Republican presidential candidate to a Nazi, but I would leave it right here. Basically, Stephen Colbert is saying that if you care about the fact that jihadists are on the march worldwide and you want to do something about it, then you are a Nazi. And conversely, President Obama is completely blameless while this jihad metastasizes under his watch for the last 8 years.
Can I ask you a question? Are you Jewish?
I am.
Are you Jewish, Liz?
I am.
Okay, you're not Jewish, are you? You're Jewish too?
Yep. Trifecta.
Three Jews and a Catholic. Okay.
Sounds like the beginning of a bad joke.
How many Jews does it take to screw in a light bulb? Three. And a Catholic will tell them. All right. All seriousness, I mean, the three of you. As Jews, are you insulted by that?
I think that I expect it from the media. I think the anyone who takes a position that is antithetical to what the left's position is, and in particular with someone with Trump's kind of rhetoric, I think this is to be expected, and let them speak for themselves in terms of comparing Nazism to someone that wants to keep the country safe.
I am offended by this. I will also say that I posted something on my own Facebook page yesterday about a store being called, named after Hitler, and people are going crazy and how it's so appropriate and it's so great and cheers around the world for a store named Hitler. Like, there's something really wrong. I'm not laughing about this. I'm not laughing about calling people Nazis or comparing our political. It's not even in good faith. It's not in good fun, and I'm not laughing, and it's not funny.
I think it's inappropriate too, and I am offended by it. As someone whose relatives could have been killed, or 100%. If it was happening today, I could have been killed by Nazis.
Yeah,
it's offensive. It's viscerally and otherwise offensive.
I know somebody whose kid was involved in a thing where somebody else in their school actually wrote, you know, a SWAT sticker on the school. Kid was kicked out of school. Mm-hmm. I mean, the kid was kicked out of school.
And the kid should have been kicked out of school.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And now you've got a guy who's getting paid millions of dollars, reaching millions of people, taking something like, I could just tell you this, if I was a Jew, I'd be outside CBS studios if that's where he is, saying, you got to be kidding me.
You know what really bothers me about it is that there are modern day Nazis on the march today who want to annihilate Jews, Christians, and everyone else in the world who doesn't subscribe to their belief system. And those are the people who should be called Nazis, and those are the people who should be hectored, and Stephen Colbert should inform his audience about. And that's the jihadists that are on the march that want to annihilate Israel first and America second.
You know, the other problem I have with this is that, I don't watch this guy's show. I just don't. I don't like him. I've never liked him. I don't like Comedy Central. I don't like the other guy who used to be on there too, Jon Stewart.
But you like Samantha Bee's show. It's a smart show.
You know, there's only one show on television I watch, and that's when you're on it, Liz. And it's this one. I just don't. I don't watch TV. But I catch these clips, and I know this guy's ratings is pretty much, they're in the tank. I mean, I think he's the worst one in terms of nighttime stuff. But I have been watching his clips lately because he's been very vocal about this whole thing that took place in Orlando. He's very passionate about the gays and very passionate about how we're shooting everybody with guns. And meanwhile, he is so insensitive to something to where people were burned in ovens. I just don't get it.
And led to their death. I mean, in masses, in masses.
Millions and millions and millions of Jews.
I mean, we
have
museums all over this country and around the world.
It's not funny. There's no laughing matter about this. I'm sorry to interrupt. It really boils my blood.
Yeah, me too. Me too. I think it would boil anyone's blood, not necessarily being a Jew of any religion. The same way if any other religion or any other group of people were picked on or
massacred
the way that the Jews
were. Gas chambers, the children, the families, it just breaks my heart. And having young children and having to talk to them about the Holocaust, and taking them to the museum and explaining to them that their great, great, great grandparents were part of this. Mm-hmm. This is history, and there is nothing that is funny about this.
I think anyone who goes to a Holocaust museum, especially Washington, D.C., and sees that type of exhibit, can't walk out of there, no matter what your background is, without being touched and or, tearful.
You know, the other thing here, I mean, could you imagine, I won't even say this show, because, we don't have the sort of ratings or reach that somebody like O'Reilly does. But let's just use O'Reilly.
We're getting there.
Yeah, we're getting there. But let's just talk about, imagine Bill O'Reilly got up in that same sort of atmosphere and said, here's four reasons why we should get rid of President Obama. And he does connects. Mm-hmm. And it comes out to being KKK. Mm-hmm. He would lose his job
immediately.
Instantly. Mm-hmm. This guy keeps his job because that's the liberal media.
And, the other thing about it is, just like Jon Stewart before him, Colbert is basically able to hide behind the fact that he's an entertainer to put forth very serious political accusations and narratives that do influence millions of people. And it's cowardly in a lot of respects to say, I'm an entertainer, but I'm still going to inject politics into these messages in the middle of a presidential
election. That's a message to try and whatever. I mean,
when you look at this, you look at these shows. I mean, they are absolutely assaulting Donald Trump on every last bit. And what he's trying to do, Donald Trump, although I don't think he's articulating it very well at certain points, is Donald Trump is trying to protect the American people. He doesn't want to see gays, he doesn't want to see blacks, he doesn't want to see whites, he doesn't care what you are, he doesn't want to see people dying because of, this allegiance to Allah. That being said, we had four Americans killed in Benghazi. You think this guy would get up and maybe do a skit about Hillary Clinton? They never do it about Hillary Clinton.
I think that if you watch Jimmy Fallon, I know you don't watch late night TV, but if you watch Jimmy Fallon, at least he's fair across the board. He really does, like the Jay Leno's, he does pick on both sides, and he makes fun of Donald Trump for justifiable places where you can make fun of a presidential candidate, and he makes fun of Hillary Clinton. You may not agree with everything he says, but at least he's fair across the board. Something like this is disgusting.
Disgusting.
And basically, he should either be suspended or taken off TV.
Or make an apology. Something.
Well, here's the problem, Liz. Nobody's calling him out for an apology.
I don't think that's sufficient.
I don't think it's sufficient at all. But I think it's something.
When you have that type of platform, I think you have to be suspended, and I think or lose your show.
Look what happened to used to be on a show all the time. What's his name? Glenn Beck.
Yep.
Glenn Beck got suspended because he took part in a conversation with a guy who said, I mean, referenced that maybe that Trump should be shot. It's the only way you get rid of him. And Beck, I mean, and I'm not a fan of Beck, but Beck didn't even dive in too much, and he was suspended from the radio.
And it was even, it wasn't like drawing a swastika. Right. Right. It was, what happens if Donald Trump is doing unconstitutional things and there might need to be some extrajudicial recourse to be taken? It wasn't like, go shoot the guy. That was not, it was not explicit like that. But of course, it all comes down to politics. There's a double standard in every single issue that we talk about. And again, I go back to, it's poisonous when popular culture is all about political messages.
But the other thing I think you got to point out too is that when Beck did that, what he did, conservatives like myself and conservatives throughout called him out on it. Mm-hmm. And here it is, he is being punished for it. When a liberal does this, nobody's calling him out from the other side. It is such a double standard, and it's why this country, you know, the without having the press delivering the message to America, America is forever going to be broken. All right, tell us what you think about this. DML report at Newsmax.com is the email. Don't go away. We got more videos.